All right, Pisces, we're going to do no contact. We're going to see what's going on with you and the person that you're not speaking to, chatting with, whatever the situation will be. Guys, please keep an open mind. Please remember this is a general. Some of it may resonate, some of it may not. Take whatever I say lightly. You know your situation better than I do. Thank you to everyone who's liked, subscribed, commented, any support. Thank you guys so much. If you need anything, check out the description. There's a really nice keen offer down there if you want to try one of their mediums or psychics. If I'm open, that'll be down there. Whatever you need, the cards that I use, there's all kinds of little things down there. Also want to give a huge shout out for the new cards that we got. I had a subscriber send us some new cards. I love how much you spoil me. I love you guys so much. They're absolutely beautiful. I hope I don't slaughter your name. Is it Anique? I might have just said that wrong. But thank you so much for the cards. All right, guys, let's get into the reading. Pisces, I'm getting this energy that you're attracting. You're in the Queen of Wands energy right now. You're attracting a lot of people, a lot of attention. I feel like I see someone taking care of themselves. So I see someone doing skincare, shaving their beard. I see someone shaving their legs. So I feel like, Pisces, you're really trying to focus on yourself right now. You're getting the love that you want and the attention that you want from a partner, from yourself. I feel like that's where you're getting a lot of your emotional fulfillment as well, is your self-care right now. Yeah, look, and the Hermit popped out. A lot of self-reflection on your part. Where you've been and where you're going is what I just heard. Pisces, you could be going towards new beginnings. I just seen someone dancing in the rain. Some of you could be trying to live life a little more freely, carefree. But I see a lot of self-reflection on your part. Where you've been, where you're going. Maybe getting a lot of clarity as well. Now, guys, this could be a lot of clarity on this connection, what you've been through. Maybe you're looking at things differently than you would have 2, 3, 4 years ago, 2, 3, 4 months ago. 2, 3, 4 weeks ago, whatever it be, I feel like you're seeing things differently. I see a lot of responsibility that you're taking. And guys, what I mean by responsibility is like when you're in no contact with somebody, yeah, they could be at fault. You could be like, you know what? They made a muck. But there could also be things where you're seeing that you maybe could have done better. You could have reacted better. You could have seen something on how you reacted or a decision or a choice that you made and realizing that made you might have made it out of fear. You might have made it out of trauma. You might have, if you could go back, you would maybe make different choices, different decisions. You would think things through. So again, I'm seeing a lot of reflection on your part. Now, guys, the person you're in no contact with could also be reflecting. I feel like they could definitely be reflecting on how emotionally fulfilled and happy you are within yourself. And how much you're attracting because of that. I'm getting that you're an inspiration to this person in some sense, form, or fashion. But again, Pisces, in your current moment, I'm seeing a lot of balance for you. Balance, whether this be in your brain, like you figuring things out differently, seeing things differently. There's a balanced energy here for you in this connection. What do we have? For how the person that they're in no contact with views Pisces. How is the person that they're in no contact with view Pisces? So guys, I had got interrupted just a minute ago. And I was like full blown in deep. I was in a full blown in conversation. So you guys could have got interrupted often when you guys were talking. I feel like it just didn't work out. Maybe moving forward just wasn't possible. Yeah, because I see the Three of Swords. I see someone feeling left out. Someone heartbroken. But Pisces, what I was going to say is, in that reading before that when I got interrupted, I had said the name Alex. I had also said that there could be somebody with blonde hair involved in this connection. There could also be someone who likes to wear diamond earrings or pearl earrings. Yeah, so how they view you. They view you as someone who had to make a hard choice or a decision. So Pisces, I am getting that you could have had to walk away. Now, for some of you, that's not the case. For some of you, I'm really feeling that you were heartbroken. You were feeling left out. You felt like you weren't getting what you wanted from this person. And now, again, they see this fulfillment that you have within yourself, a fulfillment that they're a little jealous of, but you're an inspiration to them. There's an emotional fulfillment you have on your own, Pisces, that makes them a little jealous, a little envious. But I also feel like it wants to bring them closer to you. Does that make sense? So it's like you're this light. I'm seeing the star in my third eye. You're this light where this person wants to literally come to you. They want to touch you, but it's dangerous to touch a star. It can burn you. You know what I mean? Pisces, I'm getting someone here had to walk away because they weren't getting what they wanted. They were getting sad, disappointed, heartbroken, rejected. For some of you, somebody could have offered something, not realizing that it was an offer from the divine then, but rejecting it. Yeah. Pisces, they could have been focusing on something that had fell apart in their foundation, in their stability. They could have not had the ability to see this connection for what it was back then. They could have had a hard choice completing some sort of cycle. Now, for some of you, they could view you as this. They could view you as someone who was very sad and disappointed about something that crumbled. They could have viewed you as someone who was really bad about holding on to the past and not healing. There's a lot of reflection in the current moment that I feel like both of you are having. How else do they view Pisces? How else do they view Pisces? Pisces, I feel like they're really sad and disappointed because they do view you now as someone that they wanted stability with. But look, they weren't willing to choose a path or make a choice. And it could have been something as simple as having some sort of communication with you or moving this forward in some sense, form, or fashion. Because, and this is what I want you to see, it's like one person understood this connection. They seen what they were getting. It was like, you know what? I feel this is my soulmate. I feel this is my twin flame. This is a strong connection. I've never met someone where I felt like I knew them before I had even met them. This is intense. I'm very attracted to them. There was a lot of chemistry. There was a lot of attraction here. Somebody knew that. One person was willing to... I just heard be the bigger person and put in a lot of effort. So one person could have definitely tried to make this work, but the other person was really focusing on something different. They were stressed out. They were burdened. They were overwhelmed. They could have not wanted something heavy, something stable, something that had responsibility to it. Because they had some sort of disappointment for some of you that they hadn't got over yet. I am picking up on that heavily. And although they view you as someone who's one of a kind, you're different, you're amazing, you're nurturing, you're caring, you're beautiful, you're smart. They could see having a family with you, having that stability, that foundation, but they didn't have the nerve or the backbone to choose that path because they were too busy focusing on the things that didn't work, focusing on the things that might not work. And Pisces, you could have seen that in this person. You could have seen that they weren't willing to take action. They weren't willing to quit making excuses or quit focusing on the things that weren't going to work out and really try to give an effort. And I feel like that, again, y'all are in different energies. With this coming out just like this, one of you was leveled up above the other one. One of you was an empress. One of you wanted growth. Wanted to nurture this. One of you really felt what this was. You knew this was something special. The other one, they were blinding themselves to what this was. But again, that's that self-reflection in this current moment. There's a lot of self-reflection. Now, for some of you, your person could be having to go through something right now where they're having to reflect on themselves. They're having to get that clarity. Yeah, and as I said that, I want you to see. It come out Magician and Seven of Cups. It was like at a time, this person was very confused about what they wanted. They could have had too many options. Options where once they didn't and they felt very overwhelmed. For each of you, it is going to be different. This person could have had a hard time deciding if they even wanted to add a relationship in their life. Again, I'm getting that heavily for some of you. How does this person feel about Pisces? How does this person feel about Pisces? Okay. So, Eight of Cups is on the bottom. So, Pisces, Three of Cups coming out. They feel like you're a really good friend, someone that they had a very strong connection with, a lot of fun with. When they think of you, they think of good times and good memories. They think of laughing, being joyous. Joyous. Did I say that right? I don't know about it. That's what they remember with you, Pisces. I see people like dancing, having fun. I feel like there was just a carefree energy between you guys, and that was something that they loved. They loved the passion, the creativity, the spark. It was nice to have that in such a time where they felt so defeated, so sad, so bound, is really what I'm getting. For some of you, you could have met them at a time where they felt like their life was falling apart. And they felt like they couldn't make a choice. For some of you, again, they didn't want to add the responsibility of a connection or a commitment or something more to everything else that they had on their plate. They didn't see it possible. But when they think of you and what they truly feel for you is that you bring them a lot of happiness, a lot of joy. They truly view you as someone that's a close friend. Even if you have had a falling out, they have a lot of love and caring feelings for you. How else does this person feel for Pisces? And it's like they really wanted to stick their toe in a new beginning of love with you, Pisces. They really did. But again, I'm getting the energy of their past just holding them back. Yeah, what did I just say? What? Y'all, stop. I can't. Ace of Cups is what I'm getting. And this is what I'm... See, she's dipping her toe in that cup. And that's what I'm getting. The urge, the fantasies, wanting you so bad, wanting to give into this, but not being able to see a way to give into this. Now, for some of you, I'm going to call it out. This person could have invested in you, but not invested in you in the way you wanted. They could have been a little non-committal. They could have wanted just the passion and, again, not the responsibility, not wanting to give you more. And with you guys being in no contact now, they're regretting that. They're seeing that they really did want more. They wanted so much more. They weren't capable. They weren't capable of giving you more. Because when we're too busy focusing on the past and the things that didn't happen and the things that didn't work out and the things that fell apart, we're not being open to what the universe is giving us. We're too busy paying attention to everything else. Meanwhile, the universe is tapping on our shoulder saying, hey, everything you've asked for is right here. Why are you? Yeah, but you took this. I can't pay attention to that. You took this. And the universe is like, no, listen. I need you to see what I'm giving you. Well, now they see it. Now they see that them dabbling with you, Pisces, whatever your relationship got to, because for each of you, it's going to be different. For each of you, I see people literally like touching each other nonstop. It was like this very magnetic connection. For some of you, you didn't even make it to the bedroom. For some of you, you only did once or twice or 10 times. But it was like there was a barrier between what you both were wanting. They weren't realizing that they really did want to give in. They really did want. I'm hearing that song, Let Me Love You. And it's like you wanted to love them for them to realize how much they should truly love their self. Again, you found this person when they felt like they were broken. Oh my God, I'm hearing Rascal Flatts. God bless the broken road that led me straight to you. That's what I'm getting. It's like this person was defeated. They were broken. Now they're realizing, I wish I would have gave in to that. I wish I would have indulged in a connection with Pisces. I feel like that would have healed me. I feel like that person would have been an amazing support system for me. But instead, I had a very flaky in and out energy. It depended upon my mood, which depended upon what energy Pisces got from me that day. That's kind of what I'm getting with this Knight of Wands. Yeah, in the moon, there was a lot that was unknown. There could be things going on in their environment that you didn't know. There was a lot of feelings that this person had for you that they didn't even let themselves feel. And I feel like everything came in at this person after you guys were separated. After some sort of change and literal death happened. Now, for some of you, what I mean by literal death, I mean you guys had to, this connection had to die. There had to be no contact. What was the connection before is no longer working. It isn't working for you guys. There's a discontent and an unfulfilled energy here. You needed to say, okay, I need more, or excuse me, one person here. And the other person needed to say, wait a minute, I had feelings and I wasn't willing to see those. I was hiding those. I was being very childlike and somewhat childish, not realizing that I was hiding things from myself as well. So again, there's things that they didn't want to let themselves feel. And I feel like they come in hot. Their feelings come in hot after a time of you guys being separated. After them realizing, Pisces, I feel like for some of you, there could have been some sort of explosion, some sort of fight, some sort of, I'm getting like a very intense ending. So it's like, we're good, we're good, we're good. Boom, we're done. And I feel like this person, I just heard, they'll come back. This person was used to you coming back, so to speak, or things working out. I mean, with the Knight of Wands, that is sometimes an in and out energy. It's a passionate energy. It's fun. It's not wanting anything too deep, too stable. But this person realizing that they truly do want a new beginning of love with you. You do make them very happy. But it took us getting here to see that. It took us getting here and them not having what they want and them uncovering those feelings that they've hid. Okay, anyways, but yeah, this person's had a lot of fear. I feel like this person's scared to reach out because it's been a minute for some of you. I feel like they can see that you're, dare I say, happily single. And it's like, do I even want to rock the boat? Whenever this person, okay, so I was going to say whenever this person reaches out, you're going to have sleepless nights, but I'm not sure if that's actually valid. I see that this person's overthinking coming in and talking to you because you are portraying that you're so happy by yourself that they're like, should I even? I mean, I can build up the courage, but what's the courage when Pisces is like, nah, I'm good. Been there, done that, ain't doing that again. So now they're losing sleep. They're staying up late at night, thinking about a beginning, taking a leap, having some sort of new beginning with you. After a hot minute, it's like they're switching gears. We're switching gears. The direction they were going in the past, they want to come back in and go in a completely different direction. They don't want to go straight to the passion if you guys did that last time. Now they want to build slow. Now they want something solid with you. Now they want something stable with you. They're scared that you're going to leave them on red. They're scared that they're going to come in and try to bring balance and you're going to ultimately reject them and break their heart. They've been trying to manifest some sort of communication through some sort of confusion. So Pisces, I'm getting that they've been trying to pull you in. So if you've been seeing a lot of angel numbers, if you've been having a hard time sleeping, if you've been seeing their name and feeling their energy heavy, it's because this person's manifesting you. Them coming in is hard for them because in a sense, they're coming in with their tail in between their legs to say that they were wrong, to say that what they gave in the past wasn't what they should have given. It's like they need to express and tell you, hey, what I did was unacceptable. I'm willing to do better and be better. But taking that action is hard for this person. So again, they're wanting to manifest you to come in. They're wanting to manifest you to come in and say, you know what? Let's have a conversation. I'm willing to do this again. Pisces, I'm seeing the number 5. So you could have reached out to this person 5 times in some sense, form, or fashion, and I don't feel like it's worked out for you. But again, I'm getting the energy of, Pisces, what I'm getting is that you shouldn't reach out, but they're wanting you to reach out. Because it's easier for you to reach out to them and you start the conversation. How are they supposed to start the conversation with you? Hey, I'm a fuck boy. I'm a fuck girl. I'm sorry for doing that to you. Like, how do you start that? If they just write, hey, would you even write them back? You know, these are the things going through their brain. Like, what should they even put? Hey, I'm sorry. Hey, do you know who this is? Because you might not even have their number anymore. And it's interesting that all this is coming to my brain. I feel like this is what this person's thinking. And I'm spiraling in a sense is what I'm feeling. I'm starting to shake. I feel like I'm spiraling. Like, okay, what if Pisces doesn't write back? Maybe I should write this. Maybe I should just say, hey. Ooh, don't say hey. What if they write back, who's this? Ooh, that's going to be bad. Should I put my name? No. They'll remember. Well, what if they don't? That's what I'm getting. That's what this person's thinking now. This is this person's thoughts. And I do see that something could have happened here again where you felt like you had got betrayed in a sense. And it could have been something as simple as you nurturing something and feeling like it never paid off. Whether it be a friendship, a connection. Again, for each of you, it's going to be different. There was balance needed to happen. Balance needed to happen. There was a burdened energy here, a stressed out energy here. For some of you, you could have been dealing with somebody who had to get a divorce suddenly, whose family or connection fell apart suddenly. I see some sort of tower energy in their environment that really stressed them out and burdened them. And I had said it in the beginning, there was something here where this person felt like they couldn't necessarily add you on top of it. But now they wish they would have. They wish that they would have added you because you weren't, look, Seven of Wands, I was about to say, you weren't a negative, Pisces. They seen it as a negative. Oh, it's one more thing to put on my plate. It's one more thing to deal with. But now they're like, wait a minute. There was a stability here. There was a foundation I could have built here. There was a happiness I had with Pisces. Pisces could have made this journey so much more easy for me. So much easier, y'all, me and my English. But I was standoffish. I was guarded. I had a wall built 10 feet high. And when Pisces would get near the 10th foot, I'd build 10 more walls. And they were only wanting to give me something stable. Something worth giving. Now they see that. The question is, Pisces, do you want them back? What do we have for Pisces and this person? No contact. Pisces and this person, no contact. We have apology. Okay, so we have an addiction and then put away the computer. Pisces, this person could be addicted in some sense, form, or fashion. Dare I say it? Stalking you. I feel like this person could be addicted to work as well. This person could be a workaholic. The kind of person who, again, doesn't want to pay attention to things. So they go, 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 go until the universe puts them on their butt. But this person could have some sort of addiction. I do feel like for some of you, it's addicted to keeping tabs on you, trying to find some sort of information for you or about you. What else do we have for Pisces? Give me what this person's feeling. I want this person's hidden truth. I feel like this person sits up at night and asks the universe, why? Why did you bring Pisces to me? What am I supposed to learn? What am I supposed to see? Why did you put me through this, not giving me the ability to see how much they were going to mean to me? Again, I'm getting a spiraling energy. It's like, now they see. But is it too late, Pisces? Because for you, it could be. For you, you're over here minding your own business, doing your own thing, thriving and vibing, shall we say? A lot of self-reflection about what you want from your future. And this person might not be in it anymore. You might have completely shifted what you want, what you deserve. Pisces, how much growth have you had? You know? I miss hearing your voice.
Oh, y'all, I'm about to cry. You know, I was getting that this person could stay up at night and cry about them blinding themselves from something so magnificent and amazing. Oh, okay. I feel like they beat themselves up for being so guarded with you. It wasn't necessary. It was absolutely not necessary, and now they see that, but they wanted to protect themselves. What if you were like everyone else? What if you were going to hurt them? Look, I feel so drawn to you. Again, they're feeling addicted to you. Pisces, they're addicted to you. Again, I feel like they could. I'm seeing someone sitting at a desk scrolling through someone's Facebook. So you might not have Facebook, y'all. It's fine. Twitter, whatever. Take this might only be for one person out there. But this person, whoever it is, it's like when they have 2 minutes of downtime and there's nobody around them, they're looking to see what you're doing. Have you posted? Who are you with? Look, I daydream about a life with you. I feel like this person wants a future with you. I'm waiting patiently. And they're hoping their waiting is going to pay off. They're hoping that you're going to reach out. But Pisces, I'm getting that, again, you've shifted your energy. Even if you think about this person, you try not to let them control your day, your mood, what you're feeling. You have a little bit of a wall. Look, I feel you leaving me behind. That's what I'm getting. You're getting a little bit of a wall. But they couldn't let you get close to them. There's a possibility you might be like somebody that failed them. Now they wish that they could go back and give it its all. Give it its all. Pisces, I'm getting for some of you that they could have chosen other people over you. So for each of you, this will be different. This could have been a third party. But I am getting that it could be a little more less of a situation, as in they chose a family member over you. They chose a coworker over you. They chose someone else over you. And this could be something as simple as an argument. Like, why do you never have my back? Why am I constantly giving? And you just act like, we're not really friends. We're not really that close. What the fuck is your problem? That's really what I'm getting. Look, I know I was a distraction from your pain. So this person could have tried to use you as a distraction. And sweet baby, they caught feelings. Now they in love. Look, I'm starting to understand our connection. Yeah, they've caught feelings. They've caught feelings. They're still guarded when it comes to you. They could be around people who talk about you. Because I don't react when... I feel like this person also doesn't react if they see you. That's shitty. What do we have for Pisces and this person? I'm fixing to get their intentions and then the upcoming future energy. Yeah. Hostilities. So they're getting very angry. I feel like they're getting really angry with how much fire and passion and how obsessed they are with you. I'm really getting that. They could have some sort of storm brewing in their environment right now. They could be dealing with a devil, so to speak. This person's getting really agitated. This person could be having outbursts as well. Yeah. Because I feel like they're getting truth, they're getting clarity, but this person's still trying to fight it. This person, for hell and high water, wants to have a guard here. But God, they want you so bad, it's like nauseating. Yeah, you get it. So this person could definitely have their second chakra blocked. See, and this person had a problem in the past where they were very indecisive about what they wanted. Their chakras were blocked. They were envious of you in some sense, form, or fashion. I feel like they could have been envious of how stable or how put together you seem. Again, it's like you met this person when shit was crumbling for them. And they had hard feelings for you. But I feel like now they're realizing that their hard feelings were actually because they were trying not to love you and care for you. They were trying to be guarded. And now they're understanding what they feel for you. Now they're understanding that they were blocking themselves and trying to fight the urge to give you so much more. Because that's what they wanted. I feel like intuitively they knew how much you meant to them. But they were blocking it. They're like, nope, I'm not giving Pisces love. No, I'm not doing that. No, we can't do that. No, 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 you can't meet my family. No, you can't hang out with me after work or after this. Yeah, sixth chakra, that's what I keep getting. Now I feel like they have this appreciation for you. But they're getting really angry, really hostile. And I feel like it's because they're wanting a new beginning with you. They're starting to see things clearly. Look, I just went straight to happy family. This person's seeing that they want stability with you. They want to build something with you. But it took a time of healing and a time of patience. It took a time of you guys having to have strength and separate. It could have been 50 weeks, but there is some sort of storm brewing. This person could be scared because they know that when you guys come back together, there's going to be a lot of chaos, arguments, and issues. So this is what I'm getting. There could be people that don't agree with you guys. There could be people on their side or your side who have very loud opinions and comments. And I feel like that's what's held this person back for some of you, is they don't want to deal with the bullshit that it's going to take to make this work. But dealing with that bullshit is easier than living without you. Period. Dealing with that crap, telling those people to kiss their butt, is going to be so much easier for them than living without you. And that's what this person is starting to see. They're starting to see that you have transformed them. That they... I'm getting like, if I keep holding back, it's going to kill me. Like, if I keep holding back from Pisces, this is going to be the person that I watch for the next 20 and 30 years build a family with somebody else. Can I do that? Can I sit back here and watch Pisces build with somebody else what I wanted with them? No, I can't. I can't. Again, a lot of hostility. And it's because, yeah, there was a walking away energy here. So my chakras were very blocked. Someone wanted more. Someone wasn't willing to give the key to their heart anymore. They locked it up and they walked away. And again, I feel like there was some sort of community. It could have been somebody, again, in their environment that they were having to deal with. There could have been somebody that they had an attachment to. Again, I'm getting that there was somebody that's very opinionated. No, don't mess with them. Don't mess with Pisces. It ain't going to work out. Your families are too different. Your culture is too different. Your ages are too different. Blah, blah, blah. I feel like you're going to get an apology for them being so guarded. Yeah, and I feel like you're going to get an apology and you're going to get clarity that there was someone that you could have known that was holding them back, that was being deceitful. This person was envious of you in some sense, form, or fashion. I feel like this person could have been envious of how... I'm getting that this connection could be very abundant if you both truly, truly, truly gave it your all. I'm feeling a lot of love. Look, angel of love. I'm getting a lot of love. I'm getting a lot of... It's beautiful, beautiful energy. I'm feeling very safe, overwhelmed. I'm about to start crying. That's what I'm getting. But whoever it was that they were letting in their life have an opinion. Guys, this could have been a coworker, a family member. This could have been a therapist. This could be anybody. Somebody here's opinion has pushed them away. And that's that hostility. Again, it's like that continued their indecision. Not being able to be like, yeah, I want Pisces. Or no, I don't want this. Yeah, and it took rest and rejuvenation, I feel like, to get clarity, for them to get insight of what they want. There could have been something here as well where I feel like there's a few people talking about you, and their perception of who they think you are and who you actually are different. Does that make sense? So it's like these people are talking smack about you, for some of you Pisces, but it's not who you are. And again, it's like this person's seeing things differently. They're starting to understand you differently. Some of you could be a psychic or a student. I see some sort of communication coming in from this person, Pisces. It could be coming in May. This person's going to express some sort of heartfelt energy towards you.
They're getting some sort of aha moment. And they're ready to take a risk, baby. They're ready to take a risk. I'm seeing 2 months significantly. What month is it? March, April, May. Y'all, May. Something's happening in May. They're going to come in and take a risk. They're getting very defensive when it comes to you. And Pisces, y'all, I'm getting tore up. Maybe that's why they won't talk about you or react with you. Because I'm getting that there could be some people, there's a negative energy when it comes to you too. Whether it be other people's opinions, thoughts, they're getting defensive. They're getting defensive and they're starting to guard this connection. They're tired of letting people tell them what to do. Again, they're getting some sort of strategy. They're ready to be defensive in this. They're ready to take a risk. Because I feel like they feel if they don't take a leap, if they don't take a risk, this is going to be something that they're going to lose. If they don't have the courage to take the action, they're going to lose this. Let's see what this one is. Keeper of Mother Earth. Love, nature, heart-centered, care for Earth. Being outdoors. Some of you could be outdoors or love being outdoors. I see a lot of transformation. I see a lot of healing, beautiful energy. Some of you could be moving in November. I picked up on that a few days ago. Y'all, I don't know. But I remember saying some of you could be moving in November. Something could be happening with this person in May. And I feel like you and this person could progress fairly quickly. Fairly quickly. Yeah. Develop plans. Be cautious. It's like have patience and make sure that whatever decision you make with this person, you have an inner peace when you make it. Don't make a decision and do something and feel uneasy about it. That's what I feel like the universe is telling you. I feel like this person is trying to plan their next action. Again, I'm getting a lot of hostility. I'm getting overwhelmed energy. And it's like this person's ready, but they know that there's some sort of details. Again, this could be something as communication. What are they going to say when they come in? What are they going to say to you? Are they going to tell you all the truth that so-and-so, that Sarah got in the way, that Nikki got in the way? Are they going to tell you that John is the reason that they couldn't be with you? Are they going to tell you that Derek was running his mouth and said that you're messing with A, B, C, and D, when in all reality, the only person you were paying attention to was this person? Again, I feel like they're going to come in and tell you everything. They're feeling drawn to come in and talk to you. They feel like there's things that they need to tell you. And if you guys are psychic or have some sort of gift, one, I feel like you're very protected at this time. But two, I feel like you can feel it. I feel like you can feel that this person wants to come talk to you. And I feel like you have a lot of love in your heart for this person, but I'm getting there's water under the bridge. It is what it is. There's water under the bridge. There's water under the bridge. There could be something happening this Saturday, Pisces, where you're going to have to set some sort of boundary. Now, guys, this could be a boundary within yourself. This could be a boundary within yourself getting some sort of discipline, some sort of rule set up. But I feel like you're going to push through this. I also see something coming in really good for you in August. I'm seeing a lot of money. It's something that you've really harvested and put a lot of effort into. But I'm seeing something develop significantly in August. And it's because you've been responsible. You've paid attention to the details and you've done what you needed to do. I see things balancing out for you, Pisces. All right, we're going to leave that here for today. Have a blessed day.